Today on Celebrity Sweat, we're in New Orleans, surrounded by NBA greats and the finest chefs. We have some Saints, we have some Pelicans.
Everything that's on the menu is fresh and right. Season.
And that, my friend, is blackened drum.
With the very, very best of football and the very, very best of basketball, professional athlete who plays football as intense as this guy knows the importance of stretching.
Hey, yo, it's DJ Khaled. Make sure you watch Celebrity Sweat. We're going to be talking about wins, shining, and we're going to continue to win more. Bless up.
I'm Eric the Trainer, and welcome back to Celebrity Sweat. Well, today we are in the heart of New Orleans, Louisiana. It's beautiful. It's the Big Easy. I am with my pal, Tae Bo creator Billy Blanks. And Billy, how do you feel to be back in New Orleans?
It's awesome, Eric, to be back here. It's a beautiful city, and I'm really waiting for the excitement of the All-Star Game.
Well, you guys are in luck because we are going to be with New Orleans' top athletes, top chefs. All of the stars are with us. We're right here at Celebrity Sweat. You are going to see it all. Not only was it NBA All-Star Weekend in New Orleans, but Mardi Gras season was in full effect, so we knew we were in for a wild time. First, we stopped by Dominica Restaurant to join James Beard Award-winning chef Alon Shaya and a couple of NBA greats for some healthy Italian cooking.
Hi, my name's Alon Shaya. Here we're gonna be making some whole grain pizza dough. People say pizza's unhealthy, right?
Right.
You eat too much pizza, it's not good for you. I'm gonna change that all up. And I'm gonna tell you why pizza can be really healthy for you and why wheat is not the enemy. We're gonna make some really great pizza using fresh wheats that are organic and heirloom that have been fresh milled, and that makes all the difference in flavor and in nutrients as well.
Fantastic. Now guys, as NBA players, do you eat a lot of pizza?
Lots of pizza. Not necessarily wheat pizza, but a lot of pizza.
Awesome. And travel schedule wise, do you grab pizza on the road?
It's quick and easy to go, but I hope the trainer's not watching right now. But
so we're gonna get our hands dirty and make some pizza with some great fresh milled flour.
Let's
do
Morgan,
why don't you get these guys working? Get them
all
dirty.
Right. Okay, let's start with the water. So we're gonna get our water in the bowl. Yeah. And then we'll add the yeast to it and we'll let it kind of just, we'll stir it around. Grown in Louisiana and milled just a few days ago, so as fresh as we can get it.
Yeah, and you know, that really makes the big difference about why the flour is healthier for you. So you can tell your trainer, be like, hey, I found some pizza that we can get crazy with and see what they say. You see how wet that dough is? That doesn't look like pizza dough, right?
No.
It looks more like pancake batter, right? But as it sits, it's gonna start to strengthen up. Pop it into here, so there's a technique with this.
There you go.
A little olive oil treatment, good for the skin, good for the pores. And then you want to just get it, pop it right into here.
Beautiful.
Perfect. That's pretty good for your first try. Must be some good strong fingers you got. Vin, I'll have you do this last one right here. Olive oil treatment. We treat our NBA stars with like some really good hospitality here. They show up and get extra virgin olive oil treatments.
How many more steps till it starts looking like pizza?
Well, we're almost there. Once you get tomato sauce on
it,
that's when it starts to like really show up.
Beautiful.
And just spread it out nice and even.
You've done great.
Typically when we have like, 8-year-olds come and they're here with their families, we'll bring them into the kitchen and have them make pizzas and they really love it. But I think it could work for basketball players too.
Tell me, at least our pizza looks better than the 8-year-olds.
Your pizza looks much better.
It does.
Yep. And these are the kinds of pizzas that, when we make them, we put the cheese on
really
after they cook.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. We'll sprinkle some oregano on that. And then Morgan, why don't you show them what the pizza looks like?
Right here. So you see how all those bubbles that we had earlier have turned into these beautiful, nice big full, and so this is the kind of pizza that we'll top after. So we'll put cheese and we'll put fresh basil on top of it.
Look how tall that gets. All that air in the dough.
Guys, when the NBA announced that they were gonna do an exchange program where you'd be working in restaurants, was it exciting?
Yeah, it's exciting so far. So far I've learned that we're beating the 8-year-olds right now in this competition of making pizza, so we're winning. I'm okay with that.
Excellent, fantastic. Now, does this make you wanna open your own pizzeria?
Not just yet. Let me see how it finishes out, and then I'll consider opening my own.
If we could kidnap you and bring you to the grocery store in any town USA, and our viewers could only purchase five things at the grocery store with your assistance, what would those five things be?
Oh my gosh. They would be fresh tomatoes, extra virgin olive oil, some good like scallions or parsley, a piece of fish, a really great fresh piece of fish or a great steak, and then maybe like Parmigiano Reggiano.
Ooh. Parmigiano Reggiano. Hey.
Then it was time to turn up the all-star heat in the kitchen.
We run it around 750, 800 degrees.
Oof.
And that's really the temperature that you need to get those pizzas really nice and golden and to get them nice and crispy on the outside. This is the really good fresh stuff, like super creamy. And I think when you start eating burrata mozzarella, it's hard to go back to any other kind of mozzarella. Fresh basil, we'll just take that, rip it up into little pieces. This is pretty much a salad, yeah. It's pretty much just like a health food at this point. And then we got these like crazy weird looking scissors. Mm. So you can take that and start to cut like big chunks out of there, however big of a slice that you want. And you see these scissors just cut right through the dough. Really good pizza.
Delicious.
You taste that fresh grain, that depth of flavor. It's got a good nuttiness to it.
Wow.
Chess, what are your thoughts?
This is really good. The burrata takes it to a whole nother level, man. And it makes it even better because I know it's healthy.
Mm-hmm. That's right. You heard that, trainer? He's got a lot more healthy eating to do here before he leaves.
Guys, where can we find these amazing recipes?
At csweat.com.
That's what I thought.
But yeah, no.
Perfect.
Up next on Celebrity Sweat. It's so exciting. We literally have the best that New Orleans has to offer from the NBA, from the NFL with us. I'm Eric the Trainer, and welcome to Celebrity Sweat. Celebrity Sweat takes you behind the scenes to see how your favorite athletes and celebrities train. We talk to the stars about eating habits, training techniques, and we inspire people of all ages to live healthy lives.
Hi, this is Big John McCarthy with the one and only Nene, superstar basketball player in the NBA.
What's up, guys? I'm James Maslow.
And I'm Jason Doring.
And you're watching Celebrity Sweat.
What's up, guys? Standing here with the man himself, Le'Veon Bell.
I do leg lift. A leg lift crunch.
Check out the Celebrity Sweat store at csweat.com and watch for weekly training tips and recipes from your favorite stars. Go to csweat.com to experience great fitness and nutrition today.
Hi, I'm Billy Blanks. I'm here with the Miami Heat Dancers, and we're about to do some Tae Bo on
Celebrity Sweat.
What's up, guys? This is Uriah Hall, UFC middleweight contender.
Adam Pac-Man Jones.
Hi, I'm Johnny Bench, and you're watching
Celebrity Sweat.
You're watching
Celebrity Sweat.
Welcome back to Celebrity Sweat. Well, today we're in New Orleans at the Hotel Le Marais in the French Quarter. And we have a special treat because we have the very best of the Big Easy with us. We have some Saints. We have some Pelicans. Billy, we've got NBA players. We've got NFL players. We're going to do a few push-ups and have a blast. What do you think?
These guys all look like they're in good shape, so we're going to challenge them in the push-up game.
We're lucky enough today to have NBA ref Kenny Maurer with us. He's going to help us decide who does the greatest push-ups, who has the most fun, and all the action's going to go down right here at Celebrity Sweat.
Langston Galloway, New Orleans Pelicans.
Tim Frazier, New Orleans Pelicans.
Craig Robertson, New Orleans Saints.
Vonn Bell, New Orleans Saints.
I'm Kenny Maurer, and I'm going to make sure all this is kept in line today.
What are we going to be judging them on today with the push-ups?
Well, I guess a little bit of good form. Originality.
Right.
Enthusiasm. So guys, really, come on, let's do it right. I don't want to have to correct you, all right? Let's do the doggone thing right, okay? What's going to separate you, or why are your push-ups going to be better or different than anybody else?
I think mine's original, something different that nobody's going to do, I think, out in this group. So I think I'm definitely going to be special when it comes to this.
No doubt about it?
No doubt about it.
Especially with the competition? You're looking at the competition?
I'm good. I'm ready.
We never seen before?
Never?
You probably seen it before, but, I mean, not from me. You wouldn't expect it, so yeah.
It's going to be better.
It's way better, too.
There we go. Look at the fingertips. He's got it down. There's nothing I can tell you. You've done this a few times before, for Christ. Look at the chest is already down. Look at it, it's already down. Unbelievable. Billy and I were wondering what's going to make you different than everybody else.
Regular class with good form.
What do you think, Billy?
I can't wait to see it.
Me too. We're all eyes and ears. He's in tight. Look at his hands are a little bit in tight. A little bit quicker. A little bit faster. Look at the smile on his face. He's actually got a smile on his face. It's unbelievable. Look at that. Unbelievable.
I'm not going to do the same type of push-up. I'm going to change it up just a little bit, you know, have some different variations, just to try to set myself apart.
What do you think, Bill?
Hey, I can't wait to see this.
Oh, look at that. Changing it up. He's changing it up. Look at that. Oh, can't tell him anything. He's got it down.
Oh, that was beautiful. That was
probably save the best for last, right?
Yeah, that's the plan. Best for last. I'm going to, change it up and try to go all arms, no legs.
All arms, no legs?
Yeah, I don't know how that's going to happen, but it sounded good coming out.
Sure did. Here we go. Oh, look at all. Oh, look at all. Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah. All the, oh, look at that. Shade. I don't even have to ask you a question, do I?
Yeah, if you want to.
Well, are you going to make everybody, you're going to show everybody what to do, or you're going to just make everybody look bad?
Well, I'm going to show them some new push-ups, you know.
Okay. Oh! Oh! Oh, there we go. Oh. This is stuff they don't see, Bill. This is stuff they don't see, Billy. Oh, yeah, yeah. I love it, Bill. I love it. You showed him, Bill. You showed it to him, Billy. You showed him, Bill.
No, it's cool. These guys are strong, man. These guys are strong.
All right, ref. Well, now the decision time is here. We can't use Billy's because he's from another planet. But for these Earthlings, who did the best job?
Oh, you can't put me in that position. Look at these guys. Look at all four of these guys. You can't put me. I think all of them were original.
Right.
I think all of them showed a lot of enthusiasm.
Right.
And I think I think all of them did the push-ups correctly. So I don't know how would I rate them? I don't think I can do that.
Should we have them do it again?
Well, that's up to you. They did it pretty damn well the first time.
I thought they did a great job.
Do you?
They did everything that a young athlete would be looking and watching. Right. They see all different styles of push-ups and what athletes do to stay in shape.
Awesome. I love it.
I agree. I don't know how they could do it better, and I think they did everything they were asked to do.
I think they're all champions.
All champions. There's no 1, 2, 3, 4. They're all one.
Woo!
They're all number one.
They made it look easy right here in the Big Easy at Celebrity Sweat. If you ever make it to New Orleans, you've got to check out the iconic Cape Hall's Louisiana Kitchen for some authentic Cajun cuisine, where we met up with their award-winning chef.
Tell us just for a second a little bit about your background. How long have you been cooking? What inspires you to be the chef that you are today?
Well, I'll tell you, I've probably been cooking since 73. I know I don't look that old, but I'm full of grease from blackening so much. And I'm gonna do it until I can't do it anymore. But this is Kay, and that is the Kay in Kay Paul's. And she passed in 93. And this is Chef Paul Prudhomme, known for bringing our Cajun Louisiana food to the world. What we have here is drum. It's a local fish. It's really firm. The next thing is gonna be the seasonings. Here we've got a mix that's got onion powder, garlic powder. It has all three peppers in it. Cayenne, black pepper, white pepper. It's kind of like surround taste going on when you use it. More seasoning where it's thick. We're gonna season the other side. We've worked with this so many years. We know how much to put on by sight. Drizzle a little bit of butter on it, and then it's gonna go into the hot cast iron skillet.
Fantastic, let's do it.
All right, so what we're gonna do, it's gonna take a little bit of clarified butter. Just drizzle a little over the top like that. Make sure it gets even. Now, as soon as it hits this hot skillet, what's gonna happen is the intense heat is gonna draw moisture from the fish to the surface.
You ready to hear some major drums?
Time to rock.
Chef, on a typical night, how many pieces of drum like this would you sell?
played like last night. We probably sold maybe 110, 115.
Wow, that's a lot of drum. You suggest to heat up the pan before putting the drum in first.
Absolutely. And it's there's if you notice, there was no oil or no butter in the skillet. It was dry.
Right.
That's always. The only butter is on the fish.
Okay.
So then when it goes, it's not like over, it's not deep frying. It's just, you know, so you need the skillet to be around 450, and it needs to be dry.
Excellent. What do you say, Billy?
Yeah, I'm waiting to taste it.
Where's the flavor, right?
Yeah, it smells great.
We'll serve this one up today for you guys with a stuffed potato.
Okay.
And it's where we bake a potato, we scoop it out, and then when we're ready to serve it, we season it, deep fry the skin, deep fry the pieces of meat that came out of it.
Right.
We'll toss that in a chipotle cheese sauce. It's cheddar cheese, chipotle, caramelized onions, of course the seasonings, and then we'll throw in some potatoes, put it back in that skin, and serve it like that.
That sounds delicious.
This is zucchini, squash, sweet peppers, broccoli, caramelized onions. Some people will come in and say, I would like a drum, but I don't want it blackened. And then when you start asking questions, what they mean is they don't want it spicy. They think blackening means spicy, but it's a method of cooking. A little vegetable here, there. And we top it with different things. And that, my friend, is blackened drum.
Beautiful. That is it.
See the color, and it's all even, and it's got, smell that. Get a good whiff of that. Woo!
Up next on Celebrity Sweat.
So every day, you know, try and do at least 45 to an hour of something, whether that be cardio.
I do a quick warm up. First, I get on the elliptical or the treadmill.
Y'all come back to Celebrity Sweat now, you hear me?
Celebrity Sweat takes you behind the scenes to see how your favorite athletes and celebrities train.
Hi, me, Vander Holyfield. You're watching Celebrity Sweat.
Hey, I'm Jason Priestley, and you're watching Celebrity Sweat.
Yo, this is Terry Crews, and you are watching Celebrity Sweat.
Learn from the pros. Check out recipes and training techniques at csweat.com. Get motivated, inspire others, and jumpstart your workouts and healthy lifestyle today. Celebrity Sweat provides high-energy workouts, training tips, celebrity fitness secrets, and recipes from the stars. Go to csweat.com today. It's been an incredible day with these amazing pilots.
Yo, what's up, guys? It's your boy Brandon Michael Smith, and we're hanging out with Celebrity Sweat.
I'm Chris Humphries, and you're watching Celebrity Sweat.
Hey, this is Flex Alexander.
I'm Shanice.
And you're watching Celebrity Sweat.
Follow us on social media and check out csweat.com. It was then on to Harris. We have an incredible battle of the NFL versus the NBA right here at Celebrity Sweat. So, Sip, you're on the road a lot, playing football, going from city to city. How do you stay in great shape?
Hey, when I get to places like this in a hotel, I come here and I do a quick warm-up. First, I get on the elliptical or the treadmill, 5 minutes max. I get off there and I get straight into my circuit. It could be a lower body circuit or upper body circuit. When I'm done, I finish with 15 minutes of cardio, 5 minute cool down, and I'm out the door.
Awesome. Does that balance the strength and cardio needed to be a football player?
Oh, for sure. You know, for us, is we work out all throughout the week. So on those times where you can't and you're on the road, you just want to keep that going. So when you do get back to your respective city and you're really training hard, you're not out there, you know, dying. You know, this kind of helps you keep that win, keep your strength up.
The game of basketball is so intense. How do you stay in such great shape?
By working out and being consistent with it.
Does that consistency go for nutrition also?
Absolutely. I mean, you are what you eat, right? So, you know, nutrition is definitely, you know, 90%, you know, of the battle, you know, so I eat clean.
If you're on the road and you're looking for a healthy snack, what kind of things do you reach for?
I reach for fruit, yogurt. So I stay away from the sweets, but, you know, a lot of vegetables.
A professional athlete who plays football as intense as this guy knows the importance of stretching. Tell us about flexibility.
Flexibility is very important, you know, especially in my profession. One thing I like to do is always open up my hips and always get loose before big time matchups. And you always got to be ready and prepared before games and also before you work out. So you never want to pull any muscles or tear anything. So you always have to stretch before and after.
With the game of basketball moving now at lightning speed, the most important thing is core. Why?
Because, you know, using your athleticism, being able to jump and check different type of guys. And I like crunches, things like that.
No matter the athletic endeavor that you partake in, it's all about the cardio. How do you keep yours up?
you know, come in, get a nice little stretch going, then get on the treadmill, man. Get on the treadmill, 10 intervals, 30-second sprint, 10-second rest.
If you don't have access to a treadmill, can you do the same thing outside?
Definitely. You can run outside. If you find some hills, you can go up and down the hills. You can just go up and down the street, down the block. You know, you can make it work for you.
Awesome. We are going to be asking them their favorite superheroes and to show us an exercise that embodies that heroic way that they find within themselves.
Who's your favorite hero?
Favorite superhero would have to be Superman.
Why is Superman?
Because he can do it all.
Show us an exercise that embodies that spirit.
I can't do it right now. It's not enough weights in here.
Y'all heard that? Who's your favorite superhero?
My favorite superhero would probably have to be Spider-Man. Because he does everything from the heart and he does everything fluidly.
Can you show us an exercise that embodies that spirit?
I can.
I would say my favorite superhero would be the Hulk. Because he was a scientist, so he created this beast. And then we turn to Hulk. Can't nobody stop him. I would go with the standard straight push-up, man.
There you go. There's go to Super Hulk exercise there.
My favorite superhero is the Green Lantern. Put the ring on and you could do anything. It's kind of like I put my helmet on and we could do anything on the field. So.
Guys, we're in amazing shape. Man, this trip to New Orleans is a blast. What do you think?
For young people out there that's watching in, they get a chance to get some good tips and learn a lot about fitness. So it's amazing.
Billy, as you know, New Orleans is a super fun place to party, but the food is not necessarily the healthiest here. Last night at dinner, I ordered some vegetables. They came to me fried. I'm starving. Did you bring anything for us?
I brought some good stuff. We have lean protein here. We take it with us everywhere we go. And it makes you have this. Look at that.
Up next on Celebrity Sweat.
You know, do something that you love to do, and that's the best career that you're ever going to choose.
Top it all off, we went to the House of Blues to sit down with a hip-hop superstar, DJ Khaled, who is performing at the All-Star Game alongside another good friend of Celebrity Sweat, Fat Joe. What great guys. He inspires millions. DJ Khaled, it's great to have you here. And here we are in New Orleans, your hometown. How does it feel to have the NBA All-Star Game here?
It feels great, man. You know, I was born in New Orleans and, you know, I've been blessed to come back a lot. You know what I'm saying? I was raised in Florida, you know what I'm saying? But, you know, my family was out here, so I got a chance to come back so much. And actually, we're at House of Blues, and I used to DJ the Sunday hip-hop night over here. Really? Yeah, so, you know, when I was doing sound check, it brought me memories, you know what I'm saying? And it was good memories, you know what I mean? It's, you know, this place has good energy, and at the same time, it's, you know, it's real intimate in House of Blues, so I'm excited about the show, you know what I mean?
Fantastic. There seems to be a connection between basketball and great music. What is that connection?
You know, it's the culture, you know what I'm saying? It's just, you know, when we're young and we're a kid, you know what I'm saying? We, you know, most of us want to be a basketball player or, you know, be in the music business. You know, there's other things we want to do too, but, you know, it's just something that we grow up around. You know, me, I might not be an NBA player, but I play basketball, you know what I mean?
Who motivated and inspired you when you were younger? What was the key to success when you were younger that helped you rise to the place that you are today?
Mother, definitely inspiration for me, you know what I'm saying? And there's others, you know what I'm saying? I look up at Jay-Z, I look up to Puff Daddy, you know what I'm saying? I look up to my brother Joe. I look up to a lot of people, man. You know, I look up to Michael Jordan, I look up to Oprah, I look up to Obama, you know, there's, you know, I look up to some of my neighborhood friends, you know what I'm saying? Just, it's too many to name, you know what I mean? But anybody that's representing positivity, greatness, and that's some people that's uplifting people, you know what I mean? Right. That's what I'm about, you know what I'm saying? I'm about winning, you know what I'm saying? Good energy, and I'm about being a family. I'm a father now, you know, my son is my biggest blessing, and he is now my inspiration.
Man, to hear you talk, man, it's like amazing because you know, you give people power.
There's people out there that use the word cool, you know what I mean? I feel like we're all cool from birth, you know what I mean? And by us being us, that's the cool thing. You know what I'm saying? I only know how to be me. You can be inspired by others, you know what I'm saying? But be yourself because you're a leader, you're powerful, you're amazing, you're great. You know, it's on you to be great. And that's what I'm about.
Do you think you were gifted with that, born with that ability?
I definitely know that God has blessed me to bless others. You know, the more blessings you give, the more blessings you give back. You know, I am the guy when you walk in a room, it can be dark, and I'm the light bulb. You know what I'm saying? I'm always been the guy that uplifts people and make them smile and give them a laugh or motivate them, inspire them. But what I've learned through my journey is that I had to do that for myself. And the minute I did that for myself, it took me a long time to figure that out. And I just figured it out, like, I gotta do that for myself as well. And the minute I started doing that, you know, all this amazing blessings upon blessings started pouring on me. You know what I'm saying? And look at now, I got my son and, you know, just, you know, getting nominated for a Grammy, all these number one hit records. I'm performing tonight at House of Blues. I'm performing at the All-Star Game. Today I was with Chris Paul, giving back to the kids at YMCA. Amazing. You know what I'm saying? I just did a record with Jay-Z and Beyonce. I mean, the list just keep going on and on. So, like, you know, thank you, God. Thank you to my son as well. You know what I'm saying?
Absolutely. Now, your power of communication, positive communication, goes across music to millions of people, goes across books, because you're an author also, but also it goes across social media. People feel like a special connection to you through social media because of your authenticity. How do people out there find their own authenticity?
I mean, you know, the key, like I said earlier, is to be yourself. You know, find something that you love to do. You know what I'm saying? You know, I've been blessed to, you know, love to make music. But not only make music, I've been blessed to be a music man, music businessman as well. You know, a music mogul. And it also molded me to be just a mogul, period. You know, I own restaurants, you know, I have a management company. I got a lot of things where, you know, I'm gonna make sure my son's good, that he can take over the empire. You know, do something that you love to do, and that's the best career that you're ever gonna choose, because you're enjoying it.
Final question, if there was a flash of light and you were allowed to be your favorite superhero, who would it be and why?
I only know him, he's God. He ain't a superhero, he is the hero. I like that. You know what I mean? It's not made up, it's real. Like, this is, you know what I mean? He's the one I look up to.
Amazing. All the stars are shining right here at Celebrity Sweat. After this, we're going to have a little bit of a dribble and dunk contest with the chef right here at Celebrity Sweat.
I wasn't prepared for that.
I'm Eric the Trainer. I invented the NBA, and these guys were short, and I made them grow. Sorry.
Nice.
You know why, girl? About to take that.
The one thing about the Green Lantern, he can do anything with that ring, so shoot. Anything I could do with these two hands, it could be putting my hands on you. It could be.